here at Cinema North in Mattydale. I got here about 8:30 or so, or I don't know, 8:15. Channel 3, Cinema Central, was here already. I talked to them. They didn't seem to know where the letters on top of the building went. No one seems to know where they are. But they were taken down yesterday. And, yeah, I got the camera working finally. I know I filmed my face for a few seconds earlier. That was fun. If anybody knows where the sign went, please leave a comment. If you get pictures of those or film those or something. I believe this theater opened in 1956, I think it was. I have the information on my site. I'm not sure the exact year, but it closed around 1990. They reopened it for a little while. It was like a race car track, toy cars you could race or something, I'm not sure, something like that. Then it closed again and they just kind of let it rot. It's too bad they didn't take the steps to save it before it was too late. But yeah, Brandon Roth was here earlier, CNY Central. I don't know if he was live or if it's a piece coming up later. But I remember seeing Breaking 2 here at the theater. And then we walked over to Chuck E. Cheese. Got some pizza and played games. Between here and Chuck E. Cheese, this was a cool little hangout spot for a while there in the 80s. I'm glad at least the Hollywood Theater is still operating down the road. I think if they could take care of this building, it could have been something like that. You know, they'd run second run movies for $2 or something. I think it could have lasted for a while. my phone craps out again. I have my real video camera here, and I'll be taping it, and I'll post the real video footage later, probably better quality. I think there'd be a better way to do this. Yeah, I think this is gonna take all day doing it this way. Yeah, this is gonna take a while. I don't know what they're gonna do when they get to the brick part. I blame Brett Hall for this. It's all his fault. Just kidding. See if he's paying attention. He's the tear it down or fix it up guy. Oops. Some birds up top that they're getting mad. They're not wrecking their home or something. I think I saw Rocky III there too. I think I saw Empire Strikes Back and Return of the Jedi too. Maybe the first Star Wars, I don't know, I was a little young then. Thank you. There's a asbestos warning right there. The yellow barrels. And yeah, I don't know anything about this sort of thing, but it seems like there's a better way to take this down. It's like, you know, it seems like this is what I would do if I had to tear it down and I know nothing about doing such things. Oh wow, thanks 95X. And one other. I guess I'll keep going if so many people are watching. I was gonna stop soon, but I keep going for a while until my phone craps out. I remember when 95X's slogan was turn it up. Is it still turn it up? I don't know. I used to joke that they used to be the Led Zeppelin channel. I don't know if they don't still do that, I don't think. But I used to play Led Zeppelin 3 times an hour, I think. But I used to love that channel. It was my favorite back in the day. Not sure why there's spring water, I guess. It's hot, I don't know. Trying to prevent a fire somehow. Seeing why Central were here and they left. The tripod is still here, I think. Oh yeah, maybe water to keep the dust down. And it goes back to the asbestos warning too on this fence. Anybody remember what movies they've seen here? I've seen the Star Wars ones, I'm sure Karate Kid, Breakin' and Breakin' 2, Electric Boogaloo. Oh, damn. There goes the orange graffiti. their fingers. Like I'm driving it. There you go. A lot of cars have gotten here since I got here, about 8:15. According to the graffiti, Noah, Ghost 800, Bone, Sassy have been here, as well as EPH, I think that says. Really, it was an iconic theater. It's been here, it's open for about 35 years, I think. And then just sat around for another 15 or so, closed and deteriorating. Because a lot of people broke in and lived here and partied there and stuff. I don't know what's going in its place. Taking a break. All right, well, I'm going to take some still pictures and then I'll come back if they go live again. Back again. Start it up again. Keep going at least until they get this front part torn down. See what they're gonna do after that. Do it. coming on. Just missed the bricks coming down up top. I'm not sure if they get those with this piece of equipment, but I guess so. They just ripped that piece of big piece off, and all these bricks on top came tumbling down, so that was fun. There's like 10, 12 cars here, all lined up like they're watching a movie, kinda. Feel free to share this or leave some comments with your memories about the theater, the movies you've seen here. I don't know, I thought like one-screen theaters are kind of cool. You know, kind of a thing of the past now, I guess. I think we're gonna need a bigger dumpster. See all the cars lined up to watch. It's Kmart Plaza here. This guy's getting a close look. Phone is so temperamental, I don't dare zoom for fear that it'll crap out on me. That's what happened before. My screen went blank. I didn't know I was live, and I was just filming my face. That's what happened back then, so I had to delete that one. Cinema North, Mattydale. Old theater opened in 1956, about. closed as a theater in 1990. It looks like he's watering that tree on top. I saw how odd it was that a tree is growing on top of a theater. I'm kind of waiting just for this front part to be destroyed, and I gotta go about my day, but I can't imagine. Look at these big bricks down with this thing. Seems like they have to have heavier equipment for that. I don't know. I said earlier I was looking for the letters in the sign, but nobody seems to know where they went. They disappeared yesterday. I just hope they were saved somewhere and they weren't thrown away or destroyed or something. Actually a first for me. I never gone live on location before, probably because there's nothing to film, and also because my phone is from 1942 and doesn't, you know, usually can't handle something like this. I'm surprised it's lasted this long. There's quite some lovely plant life on top there, isn't there? That didn't work. They feel self-conscious, so many people watching them. I'm not kidding, I just looked over. Somebody standing over to my right has popcorn. Watching the theater getting torn down, eating popcorn. Like it's a damn movie. I don't know if you saw it, she had a green bowl full of popcorn. I Pretty much the whole entrance is gone now. I don't know if y'all can hear me or not, but I'm just talking to myself, entertaining myself anyway. Guy's blown his nose in the machine. Yeah, I'm guessing they might stop after they clean up this main part, because this dumpster is going to hold all this stuff. Yeah, I would think they've checked to make sure no one was in there. I did see some angry birds. Not the game, but I saw some birds up top that looked angry. I hope they didn't destroy their home, but looks like they might have. Not to be disrespectful to anybody, but I thought this would be a lot quicker of a process. Like, I don't know. Like bigger equipment and, you know, it's like they're picking up Legos with a pair of pliers or something. I also can't imagine the whole thing right now, because this would be a really long day, judging by how long this is taking. And they're just getting the front part off so far. think the news people all left now. Remember that the red interior, when you walked in, there was like a snack bar straight ahead after the entrance. I believe there are bathrooms off to the left and right, and then the theater behind everything. It says Bone up there. I think it says Bone. It's pretty good graffiti, actually. So we just took some time on that. There's no, Ramo from Beach Street, but it's not bad. The CMI Central cameraman told me they took the letters down last night, the sign, and he said somebody, like, they're sitting out here and somebody tried to take them, so they stopped them and had to tell them to go away, and then they took the letters to an undisclosed location. I don't know where the secret letters are. They end up in historical society or something. That'd be nice, so we can, view them at our, if we wanted to. Once again, blame Brett Hall for this. It's all his fault. And his Tear It Down series. Just joking, obviously. Leaving. I'm just gonna see what they're gonna do after they clean up this front part, then I'll probably leave as well. Unless they do start turning down everything, then maybe I'll stay for a while, as long as my phone has power. think I could drive up this close and have it plugged in. Lovely day here in Syracuse. The heat index is at 75.2%. The windshield factor is 84. It's not going to be washed out by any means. And all the other cliches that weathermen like to say. Yeah, please feel free to, whoa, that's loud. Please feel free to share this video and the other ones I posted. This is the third so far. First one I screwed up. The second they took a break and now I'm on my third one. Not sure what he's doing now. Bringing things together, I see. Try and grab all that junk. So I'll be selling pieces of Cinnamon North later, $5 each. Kidding again. I think you want to get asbestos in the mail, really. Fire department is here, over there. Most of the cars have left, it looks like. The watchers. So is that true they want to wait too much for the property? Yeah, I don't know. I think, you know, if somebody, the right person bought it, I think it could have been a nice, you know, cheap secondhand theater, kind of like the Hollywood Theater is down the road. I mean, it was a cool-looking building. I love the sign and the structure and stuff. I know, like last week we had did the piece on Club 37 where I said fix it up, and ideally I would have liked to fix this up too, but I know that probably wasn't possible. It had gotten so bad. But if they kept it, kept it up and looking good the whole time, I think it could have been fixed and it could have been a nice dollar theater or something. You know, you could have had, like I said, dollar movies, second runs, and even some local locally produced movies I could have showed here. Kind of like they do at the Palace on James Street. They could, you know, could have bands here too, I'm sure. Sounds like they're, Komatsu. Oh, sounds like they shut it off, but I guess he didn't. Alright, I'm gonna go, charge my phone battery and I'll hang around here in the parking lot for a little bit and see if they're going to do any other major demolition or not. But if it's just cleaned up, then I won't film that. I'll wait and see what they're going to do. Then I have to go about my day. But thanks for watching. Please share this, like it, and comment and all the stuff. Okay, bye. Yep, back here at Cinema North, they're still at it. They did a lot more than I thought they would today. You can see the second level now. Some more graffiti up there. There's a car gonna pull right in front of me.
Can you not pour it for me?
I'm staying in my car because I have to keep my phone plugged in. Just like in the movie, somebody got to sit right in front of you. Block the view. Watch him pull forward, right? guessing the second level is where they had the projector and stuff. The same two people have been working here all day since 6:30, I think. It's now almost 4 p.m. The guy been holding his hose the whole day. Smoking man done got in my way again. Feel free to like this, share it, comment, have any thoughts or memories or whatever. I'm sure the actual screen in there has been long gone. Since it was transformed into a different business for a while, so they probably removed the screen back then. Looks like there's three other people here besides me watching. Including Smoking Man, got in my way. There were a lot of people here this morning, maybe 15, I guess. A couple of news stations. Brandon Roth and CNY Central were here. Okay, was that at a model rocket store? I thought it was cars, but okay. Model rockets, yeah. So they probably removed the theater screen and everything back when that opened. If anybody's watching this later, I'm just reading the comments. That's why I'm not having random thoughts here. Yeah, that's cool. I think, yeah, it could have been used for a number of good reasons if they just kept it up and didn't let it rot, pretty much. Could have had bands play, could have had some cheap movies playing once in a while. Pardon the some of the graffiti up there. The Panic had some good. That's a good burner there, but I don't know about the other ones. Nothing else is really any talent at all. Yeah, these two guys been here since 6:30 this morning doing this. I was here at about 8 o'clock for an hour or an hour and a half or something. And then I just got back a few minutes ago and they're still at it. If you missed it earlier, I filmed my face for about 5 minutes. My screen was blank on my phone, my camera was facing the wrong way. So that's why it was fun. I mean, really, it's been like 9.5 hours or something, and they seem like they're only about half done. Can't imagine they're gonna finish this today. But I don't know how they would secure it really either. Unless they had like, you know, security watching it all night or something. They're live again, they started up. Around the section of the wall that had the big Panic graffiti on it. And I just met the guy from the Urban Explorer site. They go through all these abandoned buildings and they went through this and I posted the videos. They went through Club 37 and TV5 building up all sorts of things around here. Red Barn. This guy is fantastic at holding a hose, I gotta tell you. He's been doing that for 10 hours almost. Yeah, 10 hours, just about. I didn't realize there was such a large second floor on this building. Figured those four, you see those four small holes, I'm sure that's where the projectors, you know, projected to the film screen, theater screen. I don't know what I'm talking about. I remember we saw something similar in Pencan Mall when we went upstairs at that theater, the Lowe's Theater. Thank you. Anybody want a Cinema North asbestos brick? Got them for sale. $20 a brick. For this Komatsu to fall over one of these times. Yeah, I agree. The state it was in, it didn't need to go, but they just kept up with the maintenance over the years. It could have stayed open and been something pretty cool, I think, for the city. Looks like there's two other people here besides me right now. There's a lot of people this morning. Yeah, I'll come back and check tomorrow morning, see if anything's left. Because yeah, these two guys have been working about 10 hours doing this. I can't imagine they're going to go much longer. Actually, this guy over here, I think he was the one driving earlier. Maybe they got a new driver now. So maybe it is. It's a new shift, I don't know. For like the do some like a main section or major part before I go for today. Yeah, I don't know what they're doing with it after demolition. I don't think they've said. Yeah, I kind of doubt they'll finish too. It's just, I don't know how they'll secure the area though when they finish for today. I know nothing about this stuff, but I would think that one pole in the middle could come down, that Lost Horizon pole in the middle there. And that would knock the rest of that top level down, I would think. Seems to have paused. Oh, there we go. Like I said, I'm just waiting for something major to happen here before I go. I thought the second level would be coming down soon. Or, you know, the floor to the second level, at least. Looks like they did fill up one dumpster over here. Now they're working on another one. Curious here from anybody that worked at Cinema North. I haven't heard from any of those people yet. So please comment or post a separate message if you ever worked at Cinema North. I'm curious to hear what that was like. Did you ever go upstairs? What was upstairs besides the projectors? Sure what's going on. I'm sure they have a plan of attack, but it just seems kind of random what this Komatsu driver is doing. Hard to do color commentary on a destruction of a building. I can see Jerry Lawler do this. We got a couple more people here watching now. About five or six of us here. Oh, thanks, Jamie. So there were office room and two rooms for storage and films. All right. I never knew that. Cool, you can still see the holes that the projector went through up there. There's four holes on top, I think you can see them. Yeah, Jamie, you know, just if anybody happens to want to come by here later and see if it's still here, you can send me some pictures or video, that'd be nice. I'm not, you know, condoning trespassing, but, you know, if your camera happens to go in the building, you know, you can send some pictures. created quite a big pile of garbage there. It's reminding me of the trash heap from Fraggle Rock. Kid, he has no idea. Yeah, I'm guessing if they have to leave part of the building here, they'll probably have good security or police around watching it. Who knows, maybe cops have let somebody snap some pictures or something. He's not cool. Thanks, Jamie. He had what was he gonna say? Oh yeah, he's moving all these bricks, putting them in a different pile from one pile to another pile. Not thought they go in the dumpster or something. There was a fire department vehicle here earlier. I don't see any police or fire department here now. Alright, I'm going to sign off for today. It looks like he's just picking up piles of stuff. I'll swing by tomorrow, and if they're still working, I'll go live for a little while tomorrow morning. Alright, thanks everybody for watching. Please like and share and all this stuff. Bye.